and the fibers of internal intercostal muscles are directed this way. So, if we are talking about the external intercostal muscle, when they contract, pulls the rib outwards. Jab ribs bahar wali side aayengi, to volume will increase, pressure will decrease, hence inspiration takes place. As the lungs held tightly against the thoracic cavity increases the dimension of thoracic cavity, results in expansion of lungs, reduces pressure below atmospheric pressure. Therefore, atmospheric pressure kya hai? Atmospheric pressure is high and lungs pressure is low. From high pressure outside, jahan pressure zyada hai, wahan se into the lungs, jahan pressure kam hai. Air goes inside until pressure becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. Air goes inside until the pressure becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. Hence, on reaching the lungs, fresh air is distributed by bronchi to bronchioles, then to alveolar duct to the alveoli, where exchange of gases takes place. And hence, fresh air comes in and foul air comes out. Similarly, internal intercostal muscles help in the expiration. And expiration is less active process. Inspiration is more active process. Expiration is less active process. Relaxation of inspiratory muscles. Diaphragms convex. Again, the diaphragm becomes convex in shape. This will flat to convex. During expiration ke vakti ye fir se convex shape ko jayega. To volume decreases. Pressure increases and from high pressure to low pressure, air moves. Contraction of internal intercostal muscles pulls the rib backward and inward. And now here contraction of internal. In inspiration, there was contraction of external intercostal muscles. In expiration, there is contraction of internal intercostal muscles which will pull inward, decrease the thoracic cavity and lungs raises the pressure of air in. And the air pressure increases in the lungs.